Hi, it's Bob Kraft of tennisministry.org. I'm here in Hong Kong at the beautiful Elim Full Gospel Church, my church that I attend. And following this up with the pro players on a series, today we're going to talk about Virginie Razzano. And she's been in the news at the French Open because her coach and her, actually I could say her husband, passed away just a week ago, and he was someone I knew. I'd like to share a little bit about that. I met her when I first went on the tour, and her boyfriend at that time, Stefan. And what happened was that she was French and spoke reasonably good English. Her boyfriend did not, Stefan, but he could speak and communicate basics. So it was a bit tough. And they were introduced to me because I'm a pastor, and they were very interested in a spiritual, Christian spiritual life, and they wanted to know more, and they wanted to talk, and they wanted to fellowship, and I was glad to do that. And I would spend time with them off and on as the years went on. And what happened was that both of them wanted to talk about Christ, Virginia, but Stefan wanted to talk more. You know, it was more of a heartfelt from his heart. And for Virginia, it was from her heart, but it was also just a being polite kind of conversation. Stefan was different. And one thing that I noticed about her coach, and the reason I'll explain why I would consider him her husband, is because he had brain cancer. And he shared that with me. He could not hardly walk. He had trouble talking. And when I met him back in the early 2000s, he had trouble talking. And he shared that with me. He said, I've been sick, and I'm cancer. And I prayed for his health, for his healing. And I also prayed for him to accept Christ. I asked him about, you know, say the year 2006 or 7. I was with him alone. Sometimes I'd see him at the tournament. Virginia would not be there. Stefan always treated me extremely nicely, very kind to me, very friendly, and I don't always get that. And, you know, when he passed away, which was about a week ago during the French Open, I cried because he was so kind to me. And I asked him, I said, we were sitting at a table together, he and I said, would you like to accept Christ into your life? And he said, yes, I would. And I prayed for him, and he accepted Christ into his life. Now, Virginia may not even know that, his girlfriend. She may just think he was the same as he always was, and maybe he was, you know. But I do know that he made a verbal commitment, and it was something he told me. We talked about his sickness and his illness, and he wanted to be healed. He said he wanted to be healed, and I prayed for his healing. I know he was sick for, say, 7 or 8 or 9 years, and he had a relatively healthy lifestyle. He actually improved from the first time I saw him to until just a few months before he passed away. He was actually very normal. He could walk, he could talk. He wouldn't, before he would kind of drag his foot or his arm, you know, one part of his body, side of his body wasn't working very well. And that all disappeared. Now, I could almost say that was a miraculous healing, because I remember what he was like when he first got sick, and I remember we prayed, and I remember there was that period of time where he was actually very normal, and he could talk. And then in the last few months of his life, he was ill. And I did not know that, because I haven't been traveling on the woman's tour, and I haven't been on the tour as much as I was before. So I didn't see him as much. He and Stefan and Virginia and I ran into each other at a cafe in New York City during the U.S. Open, and I sat down with them, and it was very early in the morning, and we had a breakfast together, and we talked and friendly to each other. You know, so I would see them off and on during the tournaments. The last I saw her was at a tournament, maybe the Pilot Pen, just before the U.S. Open. I told her, I was sorry I wasn't at the Forest Hills, because she had won the tournament, one of the pre-tournaments before the U.S. Open the year before, and I wasn't there. I wanted to go there, but I didn't go to the tournament. And I said, I promise you I'll go to this tournament in the future. And that's the last I saw her. I don't remember if Stefan was with her or not, but what I'd like to say, the reason that I would say they're married, they never they never went to a church and got married in a church. They were together as a couple for, I think, 9 years, and they had a commitment to each other, both spiritually and physically. They were living together as a couple, and they, you know, in France, very few people actually believe in the church anymore. And I think that's kind of where they were. They believed in Christ, but they really didn't follow the church as in what happens in France. And they were definitely a couple. They were definitely committed to each other. And I believe that God honored that. And, you know, if I had seen them in recent times, I would have said to them, would you like to formally get married? And I would perform the ceremony as an ordained minister. Or, you know, would you like to go to a church and be married under Christ in a church setting? That would have been what I would have said to them if I had been given the opportunity. But I do know that Stefan accepted Christ. He passed away, and it was all in the press in the French Open because Virginia had gone to the French Open while he was when he passed away, and he had told her, "Go back to the French Open and play for me." And she did, and some of the players are wearing black ribbons on in remembrance of him. And so that's the situation with Virginia, and I'm sure she's grieving. We need to pray for her, but I also pray that people will come around her to share the true gospel of Christ with her, and she will come and really turn her life over to Christ in a real and meaningful way and become very active as a Christian. And I'm just thankful that I got to know Stefan, and I'm sorry that he's passed away. But I also know that I had some part in his life, and that he's in heaven right now, waiting for others to join him.